Good morning, students. Now we are going to understand the concept of utility. What do you mean by utility? Utility means usefulness. In economics, utility is the want satisfying power of a commodity or a service. It is in the goods and services for an individual consumer at a particular time and at a particular place. What is utility? ஒரு ப்ராடக்ட் கமாடிட்டி ஏதாவது நம்ம கன்சியூம் பண்ணால் அதுலேருந்து கிடைக்கக்கூடிய அந்த பயன்பாடு, நமக்கு கிடைக்கக்கூடிய அந்த ஹாப்பினஸ், ப்ளஷர், என்ஜாய்மெண்ட் எல்லாமே என்ன நம்ம வந்து இங்கே டினோட் பண்ணுறோன்னா யூட்டிலிட்டி, அதாவது பயன்பாடு, ஒரு பொருளிலிருந்து கிடைக்கக்கூடிய யூஸ்ஃபுல்னஸ், அதுதான் யூட்டிலிட்டின்னு நம்ம மீன் பண்ணுறோம். அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட்? This will be in 2-mark question. What do you mean by utility market? Utility refers to the want satisfying power of a commodity. Characteristics of utility. Utility is psychological. It depends on the consumer's mental attitude. For example, a vegetarian derives no utility from mutton. Utility is not equivalent to usefulness. For example, a smoker derives utility from a cigarette, but his health gets affected. Utility is not the same as pleasure. A sick person derives utility from taking a medicine, but definitely it is not providing pleasure. Utility is personal and relative. An individual obtains a varied utility from one and the same good in different situation and places. Utility is the function of the intensity of human want. An individual consumer faces a tendency of diminishing utility. Utility is a subjective concept. It cannot be measured objectively and it cannot be measured numerically. Utility அப்படிங்கிற concept வந்து entirely it is a subjective. It is a ரிலேட்டட் டு அவர் மென்டல் ஆட்டிடியூட். இதை வந்து நம்ம வந்து நியூமெரிக்கல் டேர்ம்லேயோ அல்லது வேறு ஏதோ மெஷரோலையோ நம்மளால் மெஷர் பண்ண முடியாது. ஒன்லி இதை வந்து நம்மளால் வி கேன் ஃபீல் இட், என்ஜாய் இட். யூட்டிலிட்டி ஹேஸ் நோ எத்திக்கல் ஆர் மாரல் சிக்னிஃபிகன்ஸ். ஃபார் எக்ஸாம்பிள், குக் டிரைவ்ஸ் யூட்டிலிட்டி ஃப்ரம் யா நைஃப் யூஸிங் விச் ஹி கட் சம் வெஜிடபிள்ஸ் and a killer wants to stab his enemy by that knife. In economics, a commodity has utility if it satisfies a human want. Types of utility. The following are the types of utility. Form utility. An individual consumer obtains utility from a good or service only when it is available in a particular form. Raw materials in their original form may not possess utility for a consumer, but in their changed forms, as they become finished products, they provide utility to him. For example, cotton as a raw material may not possess utility for a consumer, but it gets a new form as a cloth, it yields the consumer utility. The form utility na oru porulude vadivathinala namakku kedaikkakoodiya and the payanpaadu. ரா காட்டனாவோ அல்லது த்ரெட்டாகவோ இருக்கும்போது அதோடைய யூஸ்ஃபுல்னஸ் வந்து ரொம்ப கம்மியாக தான் இருக்குது நமக்கு. இப்போ டர்ன் இன்டு கிளாத் மீன்ஸ் கிளாத்தோட யூஸ்ஃபுல்னஸ் வந்து நமக்கு அதிகமாக இருக்குது. தென் டைம் யூட்டிலிட்டி. எ சிக் மேன் டிரைவ்ஸ் டைம் யூட்டிலிட்டி ஃப்ரம் பிளட் நாட் அட் த டைம் ஆஃப் இட்ஸ் டொனேஷன் பட் ஒன்லி அட் த ஆப்ரேஷன் டைம், தட் இஸ் வென் இட் இஸ் யூஸ்ட். Place utility. A student derives place utility from a book not at the place of its publication, production center, but only at the place of his education, consumption center. Service utility. An individual consumer derives service utility from a service made available at the time when he most needs it. For example, clients obtain service utility from their lawyers, patients, derive service utility from the doctors and so on. Possession utility. When a student buys a book or a dictionary from a bookseller, then only it gives utility. Knowledge utility. It is a utility derived by having knowledge of a particular thing. Advertisement serves as a source of information on an object. Measurability of utility. Wants of a person are satisfied by the act of consumption. The consumer derives utility measured in terms of utils. And util is a unit of measurement of utility. Underline, this will be in one mark question, mark it. An individual pays a price for the unit of the good equal to the utility derived. Marshall states that utility can be measured indirectly using the measuring rod of money. This will be in one mark question, mark it. Next concept is price. Price is the value of the good expressed in terms of money. Underline, this will be in two mark question, what is price, or in one mark question. Price is the value of the good expressed in terms of money. Price of a good is fixed by the forces of demand for and supply of the good. Price determines what goods are to be produced and in what quantities. It also decides how the goods are to be produced. Market. Next concept is market. Generally, market means a place where commodities are bought and sold. But in economics, it represents where buyers and sellers enter into an exchange of goods and services over a price. Cost. Cost refers to the expenses incurred to produce or acquire a given quantum of a good. Together with the revenue, it determines the profit gained or the loss incurred by a firm. Next concept is revenue. Revenue is income obtained from the sale of goods and services. Total revenue, TR, represents the money obtained from the sale of all the units of a good. Thus, TR is equal to P multiplied by Q, where TR is total revenue, P is the price per unit of the good, and Q is the total quantity of the goods sold. So all the concepts are very, very important. All the meaning will come in two mark question. Then equilibrium. Stable equilibrium. Professor Stigler states that equilibrium is a position from which there is no net tendency to move. Its absence is referred to as disequilibrium. Consumer equilibrium occurs when he gets maximum satisfaction. The equilibrium of the producer occurs when he gets maximum profit. When the producer gets maximum profit, when he gets maximum profit will be in one mark question, market. A resource is in equilibrium when it gets fully employed and gets maximum payment. Thus, static equilibrium is based on given and constant prices, quantities, income, technology, population, etc. Here, look at the diagram. Here, x-axis represents quantity demanded and supplied. Y-axis represents price. At point E, the demand and supply will get in equilibrium. At that point E, at OM quantity of output, the demand equals supply. Particular equilibrium and general equilibrium. An equilibrium, when it pertains to a single variable, may be called particular equilibrium. An equilibrium, on the other hand, when it relates to numerous variables or even the economy as a whole, may be called general equilibrium. Income. Next concept is income. Income represents the amount of monetary or other returns, either earned or unearned, small or big, occurring over a period of time to an economic unit. Nominal income refers to income expressed in terms of money. It is termed as the money income. Real income is the amount of goods that can be purchased with money as income. It is the purchasing power of income, which is based on the rate of inflation what do you mean by nominal income and what do you mean by real income will be in 2 mark question market. Next, economics, its methods, facts, theories and laws. Methods of economics. There are two methods. One is deduction method and induction method. Like any other science, economics also has its laws or generalizations. These laws govern the activities in the various division of economics such as consumption, production, exchange and distribution. The logical process of arriving at a law of generalization is as science is called its method. Economics uses two methods, deduction and induction. First method is deductive method or method of economic analysis. It is also named as analytical or abstract method. It consists in deriving conclusion from general truths. It takes few general principles and applies them to draw conclusions. The classical, neoclassical school of economists, notably Ricardo Senior, J.S. Mill, Malthus, Marshall, Pigou, applied the deductive method in their economic investigations. Steps of deductive method. Step 1. The analyst must have a clear and precise idea of the problem to be inquired into. Step 2. The analyst clearly defines the technical terms used in the analysis. Further assumption of the theory ought to be precise. Step 3. Deduce hypothesis from the assumption taken. Step 4. Hypothesis should be verified through direct observation of events in the real world and through statistical methods. There exists an inverse relationship between price and quantity demand of a good. Then inductive method of economic analysis. Inductive method, also called empirical method, is adopted by the historical school of economists. It involves the process of reasoning from particular facts to general principle. Deductive method means general to particular. Inductive means particular to general. It involves the process of reasoning from particular facts to general principle. Economic generalization was derived in this method on the basis of experimentations, observations, and statistical methods. Steps involved in deductive methods are: Step 1. Data are collected about a certain economic phenomenon. These are systematically arranged and the general conclusion are drawn from them. Step 2. By observing the data, conclusion are easily drawn. Generalization of the data on them, hypothesis formulation. Step 4. Verification of the hypothesis. Example, Angel's law. What is Angel's law? According to Angel's law, the proportion of total expenditure incurred on food item declines as total expenditure goes on increasing, which is proxy for income. This will be in 2 mark question market. All the contents of the boxes are very, very important. All inside questions and interior questions sometimes ask from these boxes. So mark it. Economists today are of the view that both these methods are complementary. Alfred Marshall has rightly remarked, inductive and deductive methods are both needed for scientific thought as the right and left foot are both needed for walking. I hope that you all understand about the important concepts, utility, price, market, cost, revenue, equilibrium, income, are the methods of economics, deductive method and inductive method, the steps involved in deductive method and inductive method. Thank you, students.